Hello friends, since yesterday we have been learning one very interesting lesson, that's 3.4, how the first letter words are written. It's a story of tribal people in ancient area. There was one family. There were three members in that family. The name of head person of that family was Tegumai. The name of his wife is Teshumai. And they had one daughter. Her name was Taffy Mai, in short Taffy. They had been living very happy life, and they had been living cavalry life, means widely they had been living. Once what happened? Tegumai with Taffy had gone for catching fishes to the Wagai River. He had carried his spear with him. When they reached the Wagai River, at that time, before catching fishes, Tegumai started probing the hard bottom of the river. While probing that hard bottom of the river, unfortunately that spear had been broken and they had not brought extra spear. In addition, they had been so far away from their house. Taffy wanted to go to their house to bring that extra spear, but Tegumai didn't allow her eyes. While traveling there, she had to cross the beaver swamp, and she was very little, and so there had been chances of drowning in that swamp. So Tegumai did not allow her to reach his cave. At the same time, one stranger came there. He had been from Tevara tribe, from very different kind of tribe. As he had been from Tevara, his language had been so different. Taffy started to speak with him, but unfortunately he did not understand a single word of Taffy. Taffy wanted that he should go to their house, their cave, and bring that spear. But due to having from different tribe, he did not understand what the Taffy had been telling him. He misunderstood that girl is very, very wonderful girl, and that man who had been turned his back to the callers, that person is very noble person. And that stranger thought that if he did not follow Taffy, then that noble person would get so angry on her. So that stranger person got up, tore one flat piece of bark of birch tree and gave it to Taffy. What was the intention to give that bark to that Taffy? Just he wanted to convey that his heart was as white as that bark. It means he did not mean to harm them, he did not want to hurt them. He had been as noble as that chief, he had been as kindful as they just he wanted to convey that message through that bark. As you must have seen that thin bark of tree, the inner side of the bark is always white, so pure white, and so by that bark he wanted to convey them that he did not want to hurt anyone. He had been very kindful, but Tappy misunderstood that message. She thought that that stranger wanted address of her mother in return, but Tappy did not know how to write, so she decided to draw a picture on that bark if she got something sharp to scratch. At the same time, she saw one shark tooth in the necklace of the stranger. The stranger had owned a necklace, and in that necklace there had been one shark tooth. So she demanded that shark tooth so that she would draw a picture on that bark to convey him the address of her cave, her mother. Till that part we have learned yesterday. Now let's continue what happened. Whether the stranger man went to that cave or no, let's continue. Page number 75. The stranger man, and he was a Tevara, didn't say anything when Tappy asked for that shark's tooth. At that time, Tevara did not say anything as he did not understand her language. So Tappy put up her little hand and pulled at the beautiful bead and seal and shark tooth necklace around his neck. When Tappy noticed that stranger was not giving her that shark tooth, at that time Tappy pulled out that necklace, and in that necklace there were beautiful beads and seals. And she broke that necklace from his neck to take that shark tooth. The stranger man, he was Tevara, thought this is very, very wonderful child. When the stranger man noticed the activity of Tappy of pulling his necklace, at that time he got surprised, he got shocked. He again thought, really, that daughter had been very, very wonderful, very, very unique, very wonderful child daughter. Because look, why had he been shocked there? What happened? The shark tooth on my necklace is a magic shark tooth. And I was always told that if anybody touch it without my leave means my permission, they would immediately swell up or burst. But this child doesn't swell up or burst, and that important chief man who attends strictly to his business, who has not yet taken any notice of me at all, doesn't seem to be afraid that she will swell up or burst. Look, why had that person been so shocked? Because according to him, that shark's tooth was magical tooth. According to him, that shark's tooth was magical tooth. And he had been told that if someone touched that shark's tooth without his permission, then that person would swell up and burst. But when Tappy touched that necklace, Tappy pulled out that necklace, when she touched to that shark tooth, nothing happened to that daughter. to that child. So stranger thought really that daughter, that girl had been so amazing, and also that chief, that person who has been strictly, who had been so careful about his work, that person, that chief means Tegumai, did not notice at that girl whether she would swell or burst or not. He did not care of that girl when she touched that magical shark tooth. After witnessing that scene of that girl and Tegumai, really that stranger man had been totally shocked. Look, have you understood? That shark's tooth had been magical tooth. It's totally superstition. It's imaginary story. Okay? Don't trust it. It's totally superstition. It's imaginary story. Such thing never happened in our life. But according to the story and according to that stranger, that magical, that shark's tooth had been magical. If someone touched that tooth without his permission, then according to him, that person would swell up and burst. But when Tapi touched that tooth, at that time nothing happened. Nothing happened to that girl. Also, the chief, who had been so busy in his business, he did not care to notice that girl, whether she would burst or not after touching it. He did not care. So the stranger had been so shocked, so frightened, and so he decided, I had better be more polite. After witnessing that scene, after noticing that wonderful child and wonderful father, amazing child, he decided to be more polite than before. So he gave Taffy the shark's tooth and she lay down flat on her tummy, stomach, with her legs in air like some people on the drawing room floor when they want to draw pictures. And she said, now I shall draw you some beautiful pictures. After realizing the situation, after witnessing that terrible situation, stranger man willingly gave Tapi his that shark's tooth. As soon as Tapi got shark's tooth, she lie down flat on her tummy with her legs in air, as like some people lie on the drawing room floor when they want to draw some pictures, as like some people. She also lie down on her stomach with legs, with her legs in the air, and she told that stranger that now she would draw some beautiful pictures for him. After lying comfortably on the floor with that bark of the birch tree, she told stranger that now she was going to draw some beautiful pictures for him. Look, what did she want to draw? She wanted to draw the address, one picture of that area, to show him the address of her mother's house. Okay? It had been intention, you should know. You can look over my shoulder, but you must not joggle. Joggle means to move with jerk, to push. Write down that meaning. Joggle, to move with jerk or to push. To move with jerk. Then Tappy started to draw a beautiful picture. She told him he could look over her shoulder. That person can look, that stranger can look her drawing from her shoulder side, but he should not disturb her. First, I shall draw Daddy fishing. First, she had been drawing the picture of her father when he was fishing. Okay? First, she had been drawing a picture of fishing of her father. It isn't very like him, but mummy will know because I have drawn his spear all broken. Look, she had not been skillful artist. She was not skillful artist. So she told him that she had not drawn the picture of her father as he was. Just she had been sketching of her father, but according to her, her mother would instantly recognize him as she had drawn the broken spear near that picture. By that broken spear, according to Tappy, Tappy's mother would recognize that picture as Tappy's father. Well, now I shall draw the other spear that he wants, the black handled spear. Then she decided to draw the picture of other spear which he wanted to bring, the black handled spear. Now she had been going to draw the spear, black handled spear. It looks as if it was sticking in Daddy's back, but that's because the shark's tooth slipped. Look, there is one picture. You can see the picture on page number 77. Page number 77 on front side at right corner. That's the picture. One picture is, first picture is of that Tegumai, because there is one broken spear. One picture is of that girl. One picture is of that stranger, and near cave, that picture is of that Teshumai. And you are looking some small heads. Can anyone tell me what pictures are there? Those pictures are of beavers, correct? Beavers. The small heads have been there. Those small heads are of beaver. Okay? Now look what happened. Tappy then drew the spear, which the spear of black handle which he wanted to bring. It looks as if it was sticking Daddy's back, but that's because the shark tooth slipped and this piece of bark isn't big. By mistake, that shark's tooth had been slipped from her hand, so that picture had been looking as it had been sticking in Daddy's back. That's the spear I want you to fetch. And then she showed him that picture of spear which he wanted to fetch. To fetch means to bring. So I shall draw a picture of me myself splaining. Splaining means explaining. That's one old form of word, explaining to you. Now she had been drawing the picture of herself explaining address of her mother's cave to that stranger. She told him that at that time she had been drawing the picture of herself explaining everything to him. My hair doesn't stand up like I have drawn, but it's easier to draw that way. If you look that picture, then there is a picture of that one little girl having straight hairs. She explained that her hairs had not been straight as like looking in that picture, but that was easy way to draw hairs in that way. Look, she drew the picture of herself. Now I shall draw you. Now means after that she was going to draw the picture of the stranger. Now means at that time after picture of herself, she was going to draw the picture of the stranger. I think you are very nice really, but I can't make you pretty in the picture, so you mustn't be offended means offended, means insulted. Offended means insulted. According to Taffy, the stranger was really so nice looking, but in picture she was unable to draw him very nice and pretty. So she first of all apologized of him. She asked her pardon from him for not drawing his beautiful picture, as he had been looking so beautiful, but in just sketching she was unable to draw his beautiful picture, and she was not artist. She was just drawing some sketches to show him the address of her home cave. Are you offended after drawing his picture? She again asked whether he had been really insulted. The stranger man, as he was Devra, smiled. The stranger man, he had been from Devra tribe. He did not understand a single word of Taffy. Just he smiled. He thought there, look, he again misunderstood that message, that picture totally. As he did not understand a single word of Taffy, he totally misunderstood that message. He thought there must be a big battle going to pout somewhere, and this extraordinary child who takes my magic shark's tooth but who does not swell up burst is telling me to call all the great chiefs tribe to help him. Look, what did he misunderstand? The stranger misunderstood that picture, that according to him there had been a big battle going to be fought somewhere. There had been a big battle, and according to him that extraordinary child who had taken his magic shark's tooth and not burst, according to the stranger, that extraordinary girl was telling him to call all great chiefs tribe to help him. Look, what did he misunderstand after looking that picture? The stranger misunderstood that there might be a big war, and that little girl wanted him to go to her cave and call her tribe to help them. According to him, they both had been in critical situation, in difficult situation, so she was telling him that he should go to her that locality, her house, and he should call the chiefs that Tegumai tribe to help they. He totally misunderstood that message. That was just one picture of area to indicate the address of her cave. But according to him, there had been big war going to be fought somewhere, and so they both needed the help of their tribe, and so she wanted from that stranger that he should go to the cave and call his tribe. He is a great chief, or he would have noticed him. Again, he misunderstood. According to that stranger, that Tegumai was a great chief. Otherwise, he would have noticed. He had been a really great chief. Otherwise, he would have noticed that stranger. And now, they both had been in danger. So, Tappy was telling him to go to her, that colony, and call her tribe. "Look," said Tappy, drawing very hard and rather scratchily. "Now I have drawn you, and I have put the spear that Daddy wants into your hand, just to remind you that you are to bring it." After some time, Tappy again spoke with that stranger. She told that stranger that she had drawn the picture of stranger, and also she had put the spear which Daddy wanted to just remind him that he had to bring that spear. Look, after that, she drew a picture of stranger and put one spear in his hand to remind him that he had to bring that spear, okay, which her father wanted. "Now I shall show you how to find my mummy's living address." After completing that picture, after finishing that picture, she was telling him how to reach her mummy's address. How to reach her mummy's address, her mother's address, how to reach that area. "You go along till you come to two trees." Those are trees. "Then you come into a beaver swamp, all full of beavers." She was explaining the address by showing in the picture. She told him that first he should go till those two trees, and she showed those are trees, and then you go over a hill, dash the hill, then you come into a beaver swamp all full of beavers. After two trees, he would reach one hill. After hill, he would reach one swamp which had been full of beavers. She had been explaining the route of her mother's address. First, he would reach till two trees. After two trees, there would be one small hill. Then he would reach the swamp which had been full of beavers. "I haven't put in all the beavers because I can't draw beavers, but I have drawn their heads, and that's all you shall see of them when you cross the swamp." She hadn't put the pictures of all beavers in that bag, as she couldn't draw beavers, just she had drawn some heads. When he would cross the swamp, at that time he would notice those beavers. She had just pointed the heads of beavers to indicate that the swamp had been full of beavers, so he needed to be careful while crossing the swamp. Mind you don't fall in, she also advised to be careful while crossing the swamp, as there was risk to draw in that swamp. So according to her, he should be very careful while crossing that swamp. Mind you don't fall in. Then our cave is just beyond the beaver swamp. Then she told him that their cave, means her cave, had been beyond that swamp. And you would see in the picture of that cave beyond the swamp. Then look, Tappy told him that their cave had been beyond the swamp. It isn't as high as the hills really, but I can't draw things very small. After showing him the picture of her cave, she told him that her cave had not been as high as the hills, but according to her, she couldn't draw small things. My mummy outside. Then she showed the picture of her mother who had been stood in front of the cave. She is very beautiful. She is the most beautifulest mummy there ever was, but she won't be offended when she sees I have drawn her so plain. According to Tappy, her mother is so beautiful. Her mother is the most beautifulest mother, but she couldn't draw such beautiful picture, and she hoped her mother would not mind when she would see her picture which Tappy had drawn in play. Feels proud of their mother. We always proud of our mother. We are always proud of our mother. Our mother, not our mother, but mother in the world is always great and always greatest. And with that philosophy, Taffy really heartily appreciated by telling that her mother is the beautiful, the most beautifulest. Look from those adjectives, most beautifulest. She is expressing her love, her care for her mother. She shall be pleased of me because I can draw. Tappy was really proud because when her mother would look that picture, at that time she would feel so happy, she would be so excited knowing that her daughter could draw something. Now in case you forget, I have drawn the spear that daddy wants outside our cave. If you look at that picture, then outside the cave there is another picture of spear. Tappy remembered him that she had drawn the another picture of spear so that he would not forget. He would not forget. I have drawn the spear that daddy wants outside our cave. It's inside really, but you show the picture to my mummy and she shall give it to me. that extra spear had been really inside the cave, but Tappy wanted the stranger should show that picture of spear to her mummy so that her mother would give that extra spear from the cave to him. I have made her holding up her hands because I know she shall be so pleased to see you. Tappy had made the picture of her mother holding up her hands because Tappy knew that she would be so excited after seeing him. Isn't it a beautiful picture? Tappy had made the picture of her mother holding her hands upside because she had known that her mother would be so excited after looking him after looking that stranger, and then she asked whether it had been so beautiful picture. And do you quite understand or shall I explain again? She again asked whether he understood that address or she had to again explain. Now look what happened, whether the stranger man understood that message or not. Just 1 minute. Okay, let's continue. What happened after explanation of that picture, whether that stranger understood that message or not? The stranger man, as he was Devara, looked at the picture and nodded very high. The stranger, as he had been from Devara tribe, he must not have understood any single word of Tappy. He looked at the picture and agreed, nodded. He said to himself, if I do not fetch this great chief's tribe to help him, he will be slain, killed. Note down that meaning, slain, killed by his enemies who are coming up on all sides with spears. He had not understood the explanation of Tappy. His view was same about that picture. According to him, if he had not brought the tribe of that person in time, then that chief would be killed by his enemies who had been coming from all sides with spears. In that picture, there had been heads of beaver, but he misunderstood that those are enemies of that chief and they had been ready to attack that chief. So at any cost he wanted to bring the tribe of that chief. So he told himself, if he had not brought the tribe of that chief in time, then that person would be definitely killed by his enemies who had been coming from all sides with spears. Now I see why the great chief pretended not to notice me. At that time, he guessed why that chief had been not noticing him. Now I see why the great chief pretended not to notice him. At that time, he told himself that he realized that why that chief was just showing up of not noticing him. He feared that his enemies were hiding in the bushes and would see him. That sheep had been afraid that his enemies would have been in bushes and they would see him. According to stranger, that sheep had been so afraid that sheep must have thought that his enemies would be in bushes and would see him, so he had not noticed at that stranger. He had sat by turning his face on at other side. Therefore he turned to me his back and let the wise and wonderful child draw the terrible picture showing me his difficulties. According to that stranger, due to getting afraid of his enemies, he had turned his back towards stranger and he had allowed his daughter to draw that terrible picture to convey that stranger his difficulties. According to the stranger, that she allowed his daughter to draw a terrible picture to convey him about his difficulties. I will away and get help for him from his tribe. Then he determined to get there and bring help for him. He did not even ask Taffy the road, but raced off into bushes like the wind, with the birch bark in his hand, and Taffy sat down most pleased. As soon as he sensed the urgency of bringing his tribe, he did not even ask Taffy the road to reach that area, but rushed off into bushes like the wind, having birch bark in his hand. As soon as he realized that critical situation and troublesome situation of that chief and daughter, he rushed towards that area without asking the road. He had that bark of birch in his hand. Taffy sat down most pleased. Taffy had been so happy. She thought that the stranger knew everything. Stranger understood everything what she wanted to say. So she had been so happy. When he rushed towards her cave, she must have thought after sometimes she would bring the black-handled spear which her father wanted. Both misunderstood. As he had been Tevara, he did not understand the single word, the language of Taffy, so he misunderstood that picture. Now, this is the picture that Taffy had drawn for him. I have shown you. Okay? At the right side, that the picture which Taffy had drawn and given to the stranger. Now, this is the picture that Taffy had drawn for him. What have you been doing, Taffy? Said Tegumai. At that time, Tegumai asked Taffy what she had been doing. At that time, Tegumai asked, who is Tegumai? Taffy's father. Teshumai, Taffy's mother. Okay? At that time, Tegumai asked Taffy what she had been doing. He had mended his spear. In that time, Tegumai had repaired his broken spear and was carefully waving it to and fro. To and fro? Who knows? Here and there, to and fro. In meanwhile, Kegumai had successfully repaired his broken spear and he was testing that broken spear by moving here and there. Okay. It's a little bearrangement of my own. Bearrangement means look of my own idea, said Taffy, means some pre-arrangement. It's a little pre-arrangement of my own, Daddy dear, said Taffy. At that time, Taffy told her father that she had done some arrangement, pre-arrangement of her own. If you won't ask me questions, you shall know all about it in a little time and you shall be surprised. Taffy told his father, if he didn't ask him any questions, then she would know, Tegumai would know everything in a little while. After getting everything, he would be surprised. You don't know how surprised you shall be, Daddy. Promise you shall be surprised. Taffy again told him that Tegumai, means Taffy's father, would not know how he would be surprised, but definitely according to Taffy, he would get surprised after some time when he would see something. Very well, said Tegumai, and went on fishing. Tegumai did not ask an explanation. Tegumai just told her, okay, very well, and he went on fishing because he had repaired his broken spear. The stranger man, did you know he was a Tevara, hurried away with picture and ran for some miles till quite by accident he found Teshumai Tevindro at the door of her cave talking to some other Neolithic ladies who had come into a primitive lunch. And that stranger man had rushed to Taffy's cave. He had hurried away with that picture and ran for some miles. He had rushed to Taffy's cave. Very widely as he wanted to bring the tribe of chief as early as possible. So he rushed wherever he would see the road, but fortunately and accidentally he reached in front of Taffy's cave, where Teshumai had been stood with some other Neolithic ladies who had gone there for lunch. When stranger reached in front of the cave, at that time there had been Teshumai who had been talking to some other Neolithic ladies who had gone there to primitive lunch. Taffy was very like Teshumai, especially about the upper part of face and the eyes. So stranger man, always a pure Tevara, smiled politely and handed Teshumai the birch bark. When stranger man noticed Teshumai, at that time he instantly recognized her eyes. Taffy was very like Teshumai, especially about the upper part of face and eyes. So stranger smiled politely at her and handed over that birch bark. He had run hard so that he panted. Panted means taking long breath. And his legs were scratched with brambles, thorny bushes. Bramble, wild prickly bushes. Look, stranger had been ran from many distance, so he had been so tired, he was panting, and his legs had been scratched with thorny bushes, but he still tried to be polite. He tried to be polite in front of Teshuna. Although he had been so tired, although he had been so tired due to running from long distance, and his legs had been also scratched due to thorny bushes. He tried to be polite in front of Teshuna. Okay, then look what happened after getting that picture. What was the reaction of Teshumai, whether she gave him that spear or not, whether she understood that message properly or not, we shall see this in the next lecture as time is over. So what happened after getting that picture? What was the reply, what was the reaction of Teshumai? We would see in the next lecture. Now time is over, so I stop here. Thank you very much.